हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एंड लर्न द ऑल अबाउट प्री फॉर्मुलेशन पैरामीटर्स और प्री फॉर्मुलेशन फैक्टर्स विच शुड बी कंसिडर बिफोर फॉर्मुलेटिंग पैरेंटल्स। आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो यू विल बी एबल टू लर्न ऑल अबाउट डिफरेंट फॉर्मुलेटर पैरामीटर्स फॉर पैरेंटल्स। Pre-formulation factors are categorized in three groups. The first is physical properties of active drug substance, and the second is chemical properties of active drug substance, and the third one is initial formulation approaches. The physical properties of active drug substances are further studied by structure, molecular weight, solubility, effect of pH on solubility, isoelectric point for a protein or peptide, hygroscopicity, potential for water or other solvent loss, and aggregation potential for protein or peptide. And the chemical properties of active drug substances are further studied by potency and purity, degradation time, pH stability profile, sensitivity to oxygen, sensitivity to light. And the initial formulation approaches are no timeline for drug product, no how drug will be used, to no accelerator stability studies, container and closure, manufacturing method of the product, finalized formulation, and approach to obtain sterile product. These all are the pre-formulation factors which should be considered or which should be studied before formulating any parenteral formulation. Let's see one by one what is the significance behind studying this formulation, pre-formulation factors. The first one is structure. From structure we know the bioactive compound. Every compound or every chemical have some functional group which are bioactive or which are responsible for showing the therapeutical activity. So from the structure we know whether it is bioactive or non-bioactive. The next is molecular weight. From molecular weight we can optimize the drug release and absorption. Release and absorption are the important parameter for any drug to show therapeutic activity. Then the next is solubility. The solubility of drug is checked in water also and in other solvents also. The importance of solubility is to achieve desired concentration of drug in systematic circulation for desired anticipated pharmacological response. The next factor is effect of pH on solubility. Solubility varies with different pH, so we have to study the pH at which drug shows maximum solubility, because solubility is essential parameter in bioavailability, or it is a rate limiting step in bioavailability. The isoelectric point for a protein or peptide significant in protein purification because it represents the pH where solubility is typically minimal. Next is hygroscopicity. Hygroscopicity is ability to take the moisture. Moisture can be disturb physical and chemical stability of the drug. If you want to prevent drug from degradation from the moisture, we should study the hygroscopicity of drug before formulating the formulation. The next is potential for water and other solvent loss. Loss of solvent affects the stability profile of drug. Without solvent, we cannot formulate parenteral formulations. So we have to check whether the water is potential or other solvent loss is happening in formulation or not. Then the next is aggregation potential protein or peptide. The steady deposition of protein in the liver, kidney, spleen or other tissue in certain diseases. The next is potency and purity. To measure a drug activity and drug amount, potency means how drug is potent, how potentially the drug is going to show the therapeutic activity, and the purity means how drug is pure. The more drug is pure, the potency is more. So we have to check the potency and purity of drug before formulating parenteral formulation. The next is pH stability profile to secure stability of drug and product. The pH stability, because while manufacturing and after manufacturing of parenteral preparation, we have gone through different types of pH. At that pH, our drug and other additives should be stable or should not degrade as the pH change. So we have to study the pH stability profile of that particular drug or for that particular additives. The next is sensitivity to oxygen. There are some drugs which are sensitive to oxygen, and because of the sensitivity, the oxidation may occur, and because of that, the drug may get degrade. The degradation of drug do not show the desired therapeutical or pharmacological activity. Hence, to enhance the stability of oxygen sensitive solution by finding the way of preventing oxidation. So we have to find the way to prevent the oxidation of oxygen sensitive drugs. The next is sensitivity to light. There are some drugs, chemicals which are sensitive to light. When they come in contact with light, they get degrade. To prevent this degradation, we have to study the sensitivity about the light for that particular drug before formulating the parenterals. The next parameter is to know how drug will be used, whether it is used as a single dose or whether it is used as a multiple dose. Because in parenteral preparation, the single dose and multiple dose preparations have different packaging size, different design size, and we have to use antimicrobial agent in multiple dose use because to prevent the growth of bacteria in multiple dose containers. Then the next is shelf life to determine the period of time in which drug product is expected to remain within its approved product specification while stored under defined condition. Means we have to decide the shelf life before formulating the parenteral formulation. Shelf life is a time at which the formulation or drug should not change their physicochemical properties so that the desired therapeutical effect will be achieved at that period of time. Then the combination with other products. The combination with other products means other products are maybe additives, solutions, vehicles. We have to check the incompatibility of drug with additives with vehicles. If there is incompatibility with the additives or vehicles, that drug or that additive is not suitable for formulating the parenteral preparations. Then the next is accelerated stability studies. These studies are provide evidence on how the quality of drug or medicinal product varies with time under the variety of environmental factors such as temperature, humidity and light. At various locations and various seasons, the temperature, humidity and light get changes. So, from accelerated stability studies, we check the quality of drug at various times, and this data is useful to decide the shelf life for the medicinal product and recommended storage conditions. container and closure to select for packaging. Finalize formulation. In finalized formulation, we need to check the tonicity by adding tonicity adjusting agent. We add tonicity adjusting agent into the formulation to prevent the shrinking and bursting of cell. Because of the out or in movement of solvent molecule into the cell or maybe outside the cell, this will cause the shrinking and bursting of the cell. So the parenteral solution must be isotonic in nature and not be hypotonic or hypertonic. Then we have to add the antimicrobial preservative. If product is in multiple dose container, we have to add the antimicrobial preservative to increase the life of the product. Approach to obtain sterile products. The terminal sterilization and sterile filtration and aseptic processing. As the parenteral preparation are directly injected into the body bypassing the GIT tract, hence we are not using GIT here, so our product must be sterile, means should be free from microorganisms, free from pyrogens, because if the microorganisms or pyrogens are present in the parenteral formulation, it may cause the hazardous effect to the human being. So terminal sterilization is one of the approach for making our parenteral formulation sterile. And the second is sterile filtration for those drug which are heat sensitive. So this approach is to kill the microorganism in product and make it free from microorganism and free from pyrogens. So these all are the pre-formulation parameters for parenterals or for sterile products. We have to study these all parameters before formulating the parenteral products. Friends, if you have any questions, query regarding pre-formulation parameter for parenterals or sterile products, please comment your question in comment section. I will answer it. Thank you.